Today, your new era moms would like to talk to you about getting over the guilt. That word that we struggle with almost on a daily basis, that G word, guilt. And I know that probably a lot of you are gulping as we say that word and as you saw the title of this episode, because it's something that's very, very challenging for all of us. So I'd like to get started with Valeska. I want to ask you, why do you think that we feel so much guilt?
I think it's missing out. It's missing out. That's just for me, that's the bottom line. Like if, you know, you're running a little bit over with time because you have to, you know, if deadlines, you know, if you have, especially if you have something to deliver within a certain time frame, I feel that, and it happens to correlate with something important, then that's where I feel like I'm missing out. And that gets reinforced with me many times because let's say I'm playing with my son, especially with my 1.5-year-old, because he's in that certain milestone stage where they do very cute things. And I'm thinking, oh my God, if right now, if I was, you know, at the office, I would have missed out on this such adorable moment of whatever he just did to me. And yourself?
We'll get to this later, but I actually don't feel guilty that I'm working. I feel guilty that I'm tired because I'm working.
Good point.
But I predominantly work nights, or I work around my schedule, you know, with my son. But I think as a whole, we are pre-programmed as women by society to feel guilty that we're not spending enough time with our children, or we're not spending enough time with our husbands. You know, we're not cooking, we're not cleaning, we're not doing the laundry. So I think in all honesty, if society didn't pressure us the same way, we wouldn't feel as guilty. And quite honestly, I haven't heard one person ask my husband, does he feel guilty when he goes to work?
Yeah, you're bringing up a lot of good points, Stella. And it's funny that I also have gotten over the guilt. In fact, last week at an event, when I presented, I actually said that. I said, you know, I've cracked the code on getting over the guilt. So I don't feel guilty. I feel sad sometimes, like Valeska said, about missing out on things, but I no longer feel guilty. I also think
that's a good point. That's a good word.
And you know, Stella, I'm gonna respectfully disagree with you on the society thing. I think we pay too much attention to what we think is the perfect woman. And it's almost like working women and women entrepreneurs, we're kind of at a tipping point right now in the years that we're living. You know, our mothers and grandmothers, I feel, had it a lot harder than we did. And so we're almost having to redefine the role of the woman, not only at home, but also in the workplace. So I think that that's the reason why we struggle so much with the guilt, because at least in my case, my mom gave up her career to raise us. Mm-hmm. My mother studied accounting in the 1970s at the University of Miami, where they gave special grants and loans to Cuban exile immigrants. Mm-hmm. And my mom busted her butt to go to college to become an accountant. Her professors told her, you're a woman and you're Hispanic, you will be nobody in your life. I mean, that's the kind of thing that my mom dealt with. She graduated in 3 years instead of four, and never went on to be an accountant because she gave up her career to raise us. And seeing what she went through and knowing that now I have this wonderful opportunity to have it all, to be married to a great man and have my own business and have that freedom and flexibility, it's almost like, not only do I feel guilty with my kids, but I almost feel guilty to have my mom witness that, because it's almost like we're so blessed. We're starting to become more progressive in that standpoint. But just to bring it back to the guilt, Stella, I want to hear more about perhaps some working women that you've worked with that where guilt tends to be a big topic for them. What kind of assistance or tips have you given them to be able to get over that guilt?
I mean, one of my favorite sayings is, you know, we shouldn't be beating ourselves with twigs. You know, we're our own, you know, our own biggest critics. But I actually agree with you. I started this by telling you that I am not actually guilty as a working mom. Mm-hmm. That's pretty much what defines me. I have a working class mentality. I've worked since the age of 13, in one capacity or another. And I actually just encourage moms to be honest with themselves. I think some level of frustration comes from moms that feel they have to work, not that they want to work. I mean, I fall in both categories. Financially, I have to work. I play a huge role in, right, in the money that comes into, my family environment. But I want to work. But I think it's definitely that level of being honest with yourself. Don't feel the peer pressure of other moms. Like when somebody goes to Mommy and Me and they say, you have to work. No, be honest. Stand up for yourself. No, actually, quite frankly, I want to work, and I want my son or my daughter to know that, I was an independent woman before I married my husband.
Right.
So I think it's not living under the disguise of, I have to work.
Mm-hmm. Right. And that it also means, and I think that this can actually turn into a topic for another show for us as well about, if you don't work, you're lazy. And if you work, you don't love your children. Right. And so and just to share a quick story, actually, yesterday I volunteered in my son's class at school. The school that they attend actually has a very big we have to volunteer. So they're very, very big on volunteering and parent involvement in the classroom. Mm-hmm. So I volunteered in the classroom from 1:30 to 2:30 until dismissal. So the teacher that's at the exit door of the school said, "Oh, wow, Mommy picked you up today. That must be such a special treat." And I'm walking out with another mom who doesn't work, and she looked at me and she says, "Oh, my God, why would she say something like that?" And I looked at her and I said, "Because it's true. I don't pick up my kids every day, and so this is a treat for my children, and I don't see that as anything bad. I've decided that picking up my children from school is not a priority. I prefer to work a little bit longer so that come 5 o'clock, the computer and the phone shuts down and I give them 100% of me." Right. That works for me. That may not work for everybody. And so for me, it's, I think that there was a stage in my life where I felt like I, maybe 2 years ago, I would have been hurt by that comment. But now I've realized, she's absolutely right. I don't pick up my children. Does that mean I love my children any less, or that I'm that much of a better or worse mother? Absolutely not. And so I think a lot of the guilt that we experience is based off the perception that we think that others have of us. Don't you guys agree?
Oh, good point.
I think, parenting, and I know this because I've gone from being a step-parent, to being a parent. He's with me, me and my husband in some capacity 24/7. Parenting, there is no shut-off button. There are no hours. So for somebody, to make, or if you allow them to make you feel guilty because you didn't spend 8 hours with your son in the day, then that's not women supporting women. And that's what I'd like to see change.
Yes.
I think that you already did what I said. You said, no, it is key. I don't pick him up from school. Right. Somebody else might have said, "Oh, yeah, can you believe that? Why would that teacher have said that to me?"
Right.
And
my mom was instrumental. I remember when 8 years ago when I had my first son, I was working in corporate America, Warner Brothers. I mean, it was a phenomenal job. And I cried my entire maternity leave, not because of postpartum depression, but because I didn't want to be home, and I felt horrible. I mean, for years, I never said that in public because that's not what you're supposed to say, And I remember, again, my mother is just phenomenal. And she said to me, she says, "Look at me." And I said, "Right, Mom, look at you. You went to school in the 70s where women had no place anywhere for higher education. You were, you had been 15 years in this country. You had already learned the language. You did a degree in 3 years on a grant program, had to pay that money back, you busted your butt, and then you gave it all up for us."
Right. Yeah, you talk, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I'm sorry. No, I know you talked about, you talk about corporate America, and I recall when we had our office, and it would drive my business partner crazy every time he was looking for our marketing director and she was in the bathroom nursing her child.
Right.
He's like, every time I need to speak to her, it happens to be when she's nursing. And but it was important for us that if you're still breastfeeding and you want to do, because I breastfed my second one for a year and a half, my first one weaned himself off after 4 months. There was just no way getting him back on the booby. So she, you know, one of her goals was that she wanted to go as long as she can. So we accepted that and we wanted that. We want to embrace that. And having her come back to the office and feel she can bring her child to the office, she had her playpen right in her office, the whole nine yards. So, and going back to what you were mentioning earlier with Stella, you know, how things are changing, things are evolving, and, you know, being receptive to that, because there's moms that still want, I mean, I go to, I love the blogger conferences that, because I see they have a whole lactation center where moms can go and bring their child to the conference and still be able to nurse their child and then continue with their conference. I mean, I complain all the time how even restaurants, if you really want to have maybe more traffic going on, the best thing you can do is make a bathroom stall more conducive for breastfeeding. I hate, I was like, I couldn't do anything in there. It was crazy. And I was like, you know, these bathroom stalls need to be more conducive for parents. I mean, everywhere, like changing tables, the whole nine yards. And I don't know, maybe they don't want babies in their restaurant. I don't know. I raised my child making sure he knew how to act in the dining room and the restaurant atmosphere, because anyway, that's a whole other topic. But maybe it's a tactic for all I know. But definitely bathroom stalls are not fun. And going back into society, they should be more aware that things are evolving, things are changing. The same way now they're understanding employees love to work from home sometimes.
Right.
My mom, who works at Baptist Hospital, you know, and they pride themselves in being the best workplace out there, that's one of their things. They allow employees to work from home 2 to 3 times a week even. And again, you save so much money and gas. I mean, there's so much benefit to it. And we should, with all these virtual tools and technologies that are available, businesses have to adapt.
Right. And what ends up happening is that you alleviate a lot of that guilt that women are dealing with on a daily basis. And, you know, Stella, going back to your point, you're absolutely right. Men do not feel guilty. And it's almost like a hardwiring, you know, for a man can be away from home 3-4 days and be okay. That doesn't mean, again, that he loves his family any less or more. He sees it as that is his job, that is his duty. Yes, he misses his wife and his children. You know, it's funny because I find myself defending a lot of the husbands when I'm around my friends that don't work, you know, and they're getting all snippy about their husband, you know, oh, and he has this networking event. And I said, yeah, and you think that he wants to be at the networking event? Of course not. He prefers to be home with you and the kids, but he has to be there to grow his business or to grow his clientele or whatever the case may be. And so what you should do is support him. I see it from the other side again, because, you know, all three of us probably do, because we're all entrepreneurs. So we understand the value of that. But unfortunately, in, you know, when we were hardwired as women, we're almost hardwired with this, we just have this intuitive guilt, you know. So mm-hmm. I think that we should give our viewers today some practical tips of how to get over that guilt and to start feeling the freedom that we feel, that we're, you know, we don't have that guilt like a lot of people that we know. So do we, either one of you have something you'd like to share?
I think you hit the nail on the head, because we are mom entrepreneurs, and, you know, in some regard, we are our own boss. So I don't feel the same guilt. I don't feel guilty. I'm going to say that. I don't feel guilty. But because I'm able to pick when I'm working, you know, I've fine-tuned that now. I think I said previously, I didn't have my son until the day before I was 47. You know, I'd already made provision within my business to allow me some time off, you know, and I manage my business that, you know, just for example, say I was lucky enough to make $20,000 in a month, I don't pay myself $20,000 in a month. You know, I filter that money through to myself. So I think it's also about planning. You know, would your child have some of the things that you want your child to have if you didn't work? You know, when you make up for lost time, when you're taking a family vacation, family vacations cost money. And, you know, I think we're living in, again, in this world that, you know, is progressing very nicely, but we're working and living in a world where double incomes are necessary. You know, the cost of living, you know, I mean, what I paid for my first house at the age of 19, I certainly didn't pay for at the age of 35.
Right.
You know, there was hundreds and thousands of dollars worth of difference. Mm. But my biggest tip is do not beat yourself up. You know, make the best of it.
With twigs, right?
Yeah. Good one. Good one. That is a conversation for another day.
Okay.
But, you know, don't beat yourself up. But question why you're feeling so guilty. If you are really, really, you know, enveloped in a blanket of guilt, something's not working for you. And what is it? You know, are you working too many hours? Are you not happy at your job? You know, is your lifestyle, you know, are you putting yourself under so much pressure financially because you're living beyond your means? You know,
right.
Question, I would visit the question of why am I feeling so guilty and then try and combat, you know, those problems with answers.
Stella, I think that's such a good point. Again, I think I had mentioned it in a previous episode, you know, that I felt like I had to pick up my son when he was in preschool. I had just started my business. I had 5 ridiculously large clients and my family was offering to pick him up at school. And I felt it was my duty to pick him up because that's the reason why I had started my business to begin with. Mm. And I felt guilty to accept the help, but then I also felt guilty that I was doing it because the entire time I was on my way to pick him up, I was dropping him off, I was inhaling lunch with him, screaming at him to rush, getting back on the phone, taking out my laptop. And so then I felt guilty because it was like, I've just wasted 2.5 hours of my day and there's no quality. So I think that's a really good point, Stella, is that it took me, you know, over a year to finally see, okay, why don't I get my dad to pick him up? He's been offering. It gives him a break in the day, you know, and it goes back to the thing that I teach about building your army and finding these people in your community, whether it's family, friends, and neighbors or other moms at school that offer you that help and accepting that help, right? Because that's another thing that we struggle with is accepting the help. We tend to see that as a sign of weakness, and I like to argue that it's a sign of grace. If we can learn how to build up our grace and accepting the help, I think that really contributes, at least it's contributed a lot to my getting over the guilt.
Mm-hmm.
What about you, Valessa?